Jill got 3/4 of a full bar of chocolate. James was supposed to get 1/4 of the full bar, but he now has to get his share from Jill. What fraction of Jill's chocolate should James get? Okay, so we have here a full bar of chocolate, and we know that Jill has 3/4 of the full bar. So I'm going to go ahead and shade in what Jill has. And actually, before I go any further, I should point out that since Jill has 3/4 of the full bar of chocolate, I know that this is the same. Use that copies language, 3 copies of 1/4. So basically, I know that this is a fourth, this is a fourth, this is a fourth, and this is a fourth, since my chocolate bar was cut into 4 equal pieces. So here's Jill's portion here. And then it tells us that James was supposed to get 1/4 of the full bar of chocolate. Now, the problem here is that they're asking us what portion of Jill's part of the chocolate is James going to get. So they're actually not asking us what portion James is going to get of the full bar, because if they did that, we'd already know it was 1/4. They're asking us what portion of Jill's bar of chocolate. So what I'm going to do, just so we don't get confused, is I'm going to erase this last fourth, because it is gone. It is no longer with us. We are only dealing with Jill's portion. So this is Jill's portion right there. Okay, James is supposed to get 1/4. And again, that's 1 copy of 1/4, or one of these pieces. I'm going to use a different color here so we can see. So here is James' piece right there. He needs to get that much. So the question is, what portion of the black is this red piece? Well, you'll notice that we are no longer dealing in terms of fourths, right? Now we are dealing in terms of thirds. So now we can think of it as Jill has 3 copies of 1/3 for the whole, and James is going to get 1/3 of Jill's chocolate. I hope you found this video helpful.